Hello folks, in this video I'm going to explain about the O part of OSEMN or ROSEMN framework. Okay, and the O here means obtain. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, obtain, which means collect data from disparate data sources. Okay, and this is very crucial step because you might need to collect data in the form of flat files, NoSQL database, MongoDB, you know, kind of databases which are NoSQL, Cassandra, graph databases, okay, like Neo4j. So these are some of the NoSQL databases from where you might need to get the data. Other times you might need to scrape the data from websites, right? So that is another aspect. Sometimes you need to extract data using APIs or application programming interface, or sometimes you need the data from relational databases like MySQL, Oracle, etc. Okay, you know, although it is a task of a data engineer to provide this data, yet a data scientist or a data analyst you know, can also extract this type of data in case you know how to do it. As well as, in fact, if you have access to these databases, then only you will be able to extract it, right? And obviously you might need to know how to do it, right? So that way you need not to be dependent on data engineers. Okay, if there is a, you know, requirement, urgent requirement, then you can you know, apply these methods by your own and extract the data by your own, in fact. So I will be covering some of these methods in upcoming videos to extract data from these from actually these kind of source systems, right? So folks, this is Nitin, who is on a mission to democratize the artificial intelligence, big data, Hadoop, cloud computing and blockchain to the entire world. With this aim, I'm creating the associated content and publishing it on periodic basis in order to make it available for the entire community who wants to learn these modern technologies. Now you can subscribe to my channel or press the bell icon to keep keep on getting the latest updates regarding hottest technologies of 21st century. Now some people tend to group data retrieval, cleans and cleansing together, but each of these process is you know, such a substantial step that I have actually decided to break them apart into several steps, in fact. So at this stage, some of these questions worth considering are like, what do what data do I need for my project, where does it live, how can I obtain it, what is the most efficient way to store and access all of it, right? So if all the necessary data for the project is packaged and handed over to you, you have kind of won the lottery, right? Now that's not the ideal scenario always. More often than not, finding the right data takes both time and effort, right? So, and it's a very time-taking task, in fact. So if the data lives in databases, your job is relatively simple. You can, you know, query the relevant data using SQL queries, or, you know, manipulating it using a data frame tools like pandas. So pandas is the library associated to Python language. Okay, however, if your data doesn't actually exist in a data set, you will definitely need to scrape it from a website, maybe. So there is a very useful library in Python called Beautiful Soup, which is a very popular library used to scrape web pages from for data, or for extracting the data from websites. So if you're working with mobile app and want to track user engagements and interactions, there are countless tools that can be integrated within the app so that you can start getting valuable data from customers, right? And you know, there is one tool called Google Analytics. I am sure you might be aware of it. So Google Analytics, for example, allows you to define custom events within the app, which can help you understand how your users behave and collect the corresponding data. You could also use NoSQL databases like MongoDB if your data is not in a traditional RDBMS form or relational database form. So MongoDB is a document-based NoSQL database. In fact, there are four types of NoSQL databases. So first one is key value store databases or key value store based NoSQL databases. So every single item in such kind of databases is stored as an attribute name or key, okay, together with its value. So it's kind of a key value pair. So examples of such NoSQL databases are React, Voldemort, and Redis. Okay, now the second type of NoSQL databases are column family based database. So these kind of NoSQL databases store columns of data together instead of rows, and these are kind of optimized for queries over large data sets. And if I take an example of these kind of NoSQL databases, Cassandra and HBase are the wide column databases which are used heavily, okay, in today's world. Now there is a third type of NoSQL databases called document based. In these type of databases or NoSQL databases, these actually pair each key with a complex data structure known as document. So documents can contain many different key value pairs or key array pairs, okay, or even nested documents. So MongoDB is a document database, okay, and this is something which I'm going to cover in the upcoming videos. The fourth and the last one is graph databases. So these are used to basically store information about networks such as social connections. Okay, so like in Facebook, we are connected. We as the user are connected to each individual other users. For example, our friends, right? So these type of graphs basically depict these networks. Okay. And examples of such types of NoSQL databases are Neo4j and HyperGraphDB. So folks, this is it for this video. To conclude, I explained about different source systems and about different types of NoSQL databases. So folks, here is today's question. Do you want to know more about NoSQL databases in detail? Please share a comment in the comment section given below, and I will try to create the required tutorial if I receive overwhelming response for this. Okay, so if you are watching this video and you are not already a subscriber to our channel, consider clicking that little subscribe button. Okay, in case you have already subscribed, then click on bell icon to receive the notifications whenever I will release a new video. So thanks for hanging out with us, guys. I will be covering the next topic in the upcoming videos. So keep on watching. Thank you.